हेलो बच्चों, टुडे लेट अस सी द चैप्टर दैट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. योर चैप्टर नेम इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. सो लेट अस फर्स्ट सी व्हाट डू मीन बाय इट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. सी आई कैन से इट इन ए सिंपल वे दैट व्हेन एवर यू चेंज योर मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स ए करंट विल बी जेनरेटेड. दैट इज नथिंग बट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. सो एक प्रोसेस ऐसा है जहां आप करंट जनरेट करते हो मैग्नेटिक फील्ड को अदल बदल कर. देयर विल बी सम चेंज इन मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स और मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो हाउ द वे यू विल डिफाइन इट इज अ प्रोसेस और फेनोमेना इन व्हिच यू आर जेनरेटिंग द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और द करंट बाय चेंजिंग द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड और बाय वेयरिंग द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. क्लियर? सो लेट अस make the note of it, what it is or the definition you can say. So the process of generating current or otherwise that is also called as EMF, electromotive force. Later I'll tell you what is EMF. You can say even it is also current because from the EMF is nothing but a voltage. So whenever there is a voltage, if you make the path complete, there will be a current. Okay. So the process of generating current or EMF by changing or varying magnetic field, or you can say by changing or varying magnetic flux. So this is nothing but electromagnetic induction. Change the magnetic field, there will be the generation of the current. That is called as electromagnetic induction. Okay. Now there are some combined experiment by two scientists. One is Mr. Henry, the other is Mr. Faraday. So combinedly what they did three experiment to conclude that this is the different methods we can adopt to generate the current or electricity. So let us see what is the first method they did is that they have taken one coil. Like you have already studied or not. The coil means it will be like solenoid. It will be rounded up, but here they have not inserted any material in it. It is the in the air, that is the medium, just the twisted the coils. Okay. Now, in that coil, they have connected the galvanometer. They have taken one bar magnet. What they did, now just imagine this is your that coil. This is that coil. They have taken it in the form of two or three wrap. Now, this is your bar magnet. So, what they did is that they just changed this bar magnet position. Brought it near, go, make it go away. Brought it near, go it make up. Brought it near, go it near. So what they have observed is nothing but when they are bringing this bar magnet nearer to the coil, one galvanometer is attached. This will shows the deflection. Now as soon as they are taking away, the galvanometer's pointer shows deflection in opposite direction. Clear? So again what they did, they kept this bar magnet fixed. They changed the coil like this. Bring it nearer to magnet, move away. Bring it nearer, move away. What they have observed, that pointer which is attached to the coil, galvanometer's pointer, shows deflection. Similar, when you are bringing it, in which direction it is showing, while you are moving away, it is just showing in the opposite direction. So from this what they concluded, or even if you are in that position, what will you conclude? The relative motion between the coil and the bar magnet generates the EMF or the current. Am I right? Relative motion. Because either you make this stationary, move the bar magnet. Coil is stationary. Second, make stationary your bar magnet and move the coil. Clear? So what will be the statement for it? The statement is that the relative motion between coil and the magnet, the relative motion between the coil and the magnet is responsible for the generation of EMF or current. So the relative motion between the magnet and the coil, which is responsible for the generation of current. Now in second case, let us see what they did. They have taken two coils, coil 1 and coil 2. To the coil 1, the galvanometer is attached. To the second coil, a electric battery is connected, or cell is connected, or a supply is connected. Now when this coil is stationary, the magnetic field generated due to this also stationary. So at that time there will be galvanometer will not show any deflection. So what they did, they take this, fix this coil C1, this coil C2 is there, they just move it back and forth, back and forth. So what they have found, the galvanometer shows deflection. So from this they concluded that if there are two coils, then two relative coils that will also responsible for generation of EMF when the coil is moving. So the relative motion between the two coils, first case the relative motion between the coil and the magnet, now the relative motion between the two coils is responsible for the generation of EMF or current. So what is your second statement? The relative motion between two coil can generate the EMF or current. Clear? Now let us see the third case. So in third case, what they did is nothing but they have taken the same two coils, but here there is no change in the motion of the coil. Then how the way EMF will be generated? There is a small trick. I hope all of you know, have this experience. If tube light is glowing, at the time you just enter inside the room, switch on your radio set. What do you find? Some fluctuation in the tube light or not? That is because of the stray magnetic field, that change you are observing. Means suddenly when you first switch on the radio, once you fix it, after that you won't find much change. Am I right? So whenever there is some momentary change occurs, momentary change means sudden change, that is also called as transition. So here, same as your coil 1 is connected to the galvanometer, this coil 2, you have given a supply as well as connected a switch. What you do, just switch on from the off, or switch off from the on. When you do that, this momentary change will create or generate the EMF, which deflection is shown by the pointer of the galvanometer. Clear? If you keep your switch continuously on or continuously off, the galvanometer shows zero deflection or null deflection. The permanent position of the switch will not generate the EMF. Only the momentary change. What is that momentary change? Either from on to off or off to on. That moment alone will generate the EMF. So what will be the definition? The momentary change that is momentary change in bracket you mention either on to off or off to on. The momentary change of switch across C2 are responsible for generation of EMF or current. Now clear how the way they made the generation of EMF or the generation of current. What's the definition we have seen? The electromagnetic induction, it is nothing but the process of generating the current or electricity, or even you can say EMF, by changing the magnetic flux. So how the way they are making different methods, different approach to change the magnetic field. First case, they change the field of the bar magnet, otherwise make the bar magnet stationary and changing the position of the coil. That is the first thing. In second case, they made the change of the coil which is attached to the static field. They just by changing, they are changing the magnetic field. In the third case, they are making momentary change of the switch alone. There is no movement of the coil. Coil is stationary. So these are the three methods adopted by the scientist Mr. Henry and Mr. Faraday to justify the electromagnetic induction. Okay, now let us see what is magnetic flux. Like you have studied in electrostatic, electric flux, yes or no? So here let us see what is magnetic flux. Okay students, you can take the snapshot, otherwise you can make the note of it. Now let us see what is magnetic flux. Flux notation is phi, magnetic flux. So always notation for magnetic field is B. So hence phi B. So what is phi B is nothing but, imagine this is our uniform magnetic field. Let it be B. Now in that field, let a coil is placed. Now from this, take this perpendicular area A. So it will create some angle theta with this magnetic field. So your magnetic flux is nothing but, it is the dot product of your B dot your vector area. That is nothing but your scalar product of B and A, which is nothing but your B A cos. What is this theta? Theta is nothing but the angle between B and A. Now this is the case when your magnetic field is uniform. Now suppose your magnetic field is not uniform, means it has different intensity and different direction at different point of surface. So in such a case, what you need to do? You have to take your magnetic field as phi B equal to B A cos theta 1 plus B A cos theta 2. Like that it will, your angle will definitely differ according to the different direction and magnitude. So dot 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 dot, finally you can write it as summation B A I for I, for all you can write. This is for your phi B all. B and I. Your area will change. A1 cos theta 1, A2 cos theta 2. Your different area of surface. Different shape of surface according to that area will change or not. Your magnetic field, what you are taking, their intensity and direction also changing. So even you can mention it as BI AI. So B1 A1, B2 A2, dot 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 dot, BN AI. Clear? So this is about nothing but your magnetic flux. It is nothing but your dot product of your, or scalar product of your magnetic field and the area. That area which is outward perpendicular or normal with respect to that your magnetic field is measured. What is the direction of the magnetic field? The area is nothing but the particular surface you are taking. That surface, that normal you are drawing or perpendicular, which is making 90 degree angle with your surface. That area, normal of the area, how much angle it is making with the magnetic field? That angle is theta. So while solving the numericals, you give attention to this, what angle they are mentioning and what is exactly theta need to be calculated. Sometimes they give directly theta value, sometimes they will not give the direct theta value. You need to find out. Clear? Now let us come to the what is Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. What you have observed till now, the same thing only they have given us as the statement. The magnitude of the induced EMF is such that it is directly proportional to the time rate of change of magnetic flux. So what it is, he stated that E equal to minus d phi b by dt. What is d by dt? This is d by dt is nothing but you can say time rate. Time rate of change of what? Phi b. So what is your induced EMF? They told the magnitude of this induced EMF what we have seen the Thiel process. From that, how much EMF is induced, they concluded by this experiment. The magnitude of this induced EMF is directly proportional to the time rate of change of flux. Time rate of change of flux. So time rate of change of flux is d by dt. Time rate of flux is phi b. So the magnitude of induced EMF is equal to the time rate of change of flux associated with it. That is the first statement of Faraday. Again he has given the second statement. What do you know? You are taking coil in which it is associated with the number of turns. Am I right? So if you increase the number of turns, they have found that the induced EMF is more. If you reduce your number of turns, the EMF induced also reduced or lesser. So from that they concluded that the induced EMF also directly proportional to the number of turns. So they have written that E equal to minus N d5 t by dt. This is the second step. The induced EMF is also directly proportional to the number of turns of the coil. Clear? Now you are not asking about why mom you have given one negative sign. That negative sign indicates the direction of the induced EMF. Any expression if you find one negative sign, what it indicates that what you are getting, it is in opposite to the input what you are giving. Now we will get the clarity of this negative sign from the Lenz law. The next law is nothing but Lenz law. What Mr. Lenz told you know? The nature of the induced EMF is such that, or the polarity of the EMF is such that, it always opposes the cause which is producing it. Means simple. The effect is opposing the cause. What is the effect? Due to change in magnetic flux, you are able to generate EMF. But once EMF is generated, it starts to oppose the change in flux. Matlab jo bolte hai na, jiska namak khao, uska gun gao. Ye jiska namak khata hai, uska hi beimani karta hai. Kaun? EMF. So the nature of EMF is such that it always opposes the cause which produces it. So what is your Lenz law statement? That is nothing but Lenz law statement. The polarity of induced EMF is such that it always opposes the cause, in bracket you mention that magnetic field or that magnetic flux that produces it. That produces it. Clear? So Lenz kya bole? It is the nature of the induced EMF that it always opposes the cause which produces it. जिसके कारण ही वो पैदा हुआ, पैदा होने के बाद उसको ही अपोज कर रहा है. ये सही है कि नहीं? ये एक्सप्रेशन से पता चल रहा है कि नहीं? एंड इट इज नॉट ओनली द स्टेटमेंट और मैथमेटिकल, इवन इट इज कंसिस्टेंट विद द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी. व्हाट इज लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी? एनर्जी कैन नॉट बी क्रिएटेड और डिस्ट्रॉयड, इट कैन ओनली बी ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म टू अनदर फॉर्म. Am I right? So in my next video, I will tell you about how Lenz law is consistent with the law of conservation of energy and motional EMF. Now we have seen is electromotive force, this type of EMF. Another is motional EMF. If you are able to make movement of any rod, then you will find one generation of EMF that is called as motional EMF. So in my next video, I will upload about it. If you like my video, give like, otherwise give your suggestion to increase the quality of the video. Share and subscribe. Chalo bachcho, khush raho, mast raho aur anand se padhai karte raho. Take care. Bye bye.